Good morning, friends. In this video, I will tell you about the population algorithm, which is an important part of the literature. So, how one can understand this concept of the population algorithm? Let me see. Let me explain that concept systematically. So, our topic, as I told you, that is population algorithm. So usually the number of atoms in the lower energy state is more than that in the excited state. According to Boltzmann, the ratio of atoms in the energy state J and I at the temperature T is given by this way, which you have also seen into the Einstein coefficient. So let me explain this concept. What is this? You know, this is the ground state, this one is the excited state. Here, this statement says that in general, what happens, large number of atoms remains into the ground state and a small number comparative to the ground state remain into the excited state. It means N1 is greater than N2 in general. In general, this is true. So usually the number of atoms in the lower energy state is more than that in the excited state. And now, what is the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution law? Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution law, this law actually, here, yeah, Boltzmann distribution law, this is n is equal to n0 e raised power minus e upon Boltzmann constant into the temperature at which you are trying to find out the number of atoms correspond to this energy state. So if we have N1 number of atoms correspond to the ground energy state, this can be written as N1 is equal to N0 e raised power minus E1 upon Tt. And remember, this N0 is the total number of atoms, so I can write it here, N1 plus N2 is equal to N0. Right, so similarly one can write for the N2, so N2 is equal to N0 e raised power minus E2 upon Kt. Right, so now you have get an idea of the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution law and how one can write this. Here J and I actually represents the second and first state. J is equal to 2, I is equal to 1. So don't confuse with these notations. So now if you have to write N2 upon N1, so you can see here again N2 upon N1 is equal to this N0. This is also N0, cancel out. So you have e raised power minus E2 upon Kt, right, divided by e raised power minus E1 upon Kt. So how you will write it? You can write it in a raised power minus E2 plus E1 upon Kt when we simplify it, right? So further, you can write it e raised power minus, take out this minus common, E2 minus E1 upon Kt. And you know that this E2 minus E1 is what? That is h nu. So you can put here h nu also, but here we have to determine the ratio n2 and n1 that comes through this difference e2 minus e1. So n2 upon n1 is equal to e minus exponential power of e minus e2 minus e1 upon kt. And from this we have to conclude the statement, this one. So n2 is equal to n1 e raised power minus this e2 minus e1 upon kt. Right? So we are saying that n2 are less in number in the excited energy state, which is actually obviously larger as compared to the e1. So e2 is equal to e1 plus h nu. That is the difference between these two energy levels, this h nu. So E2 is equal to E1 plus h nu. It means E2 is greater than E1. So if this is the case, so you will get the negative result from here, and obviously the small number for n2 when you put the value at that value here. N1 multiplied some number, right, with negative. So you can write here n1 upon a raised power something x. So obviously n2 will be less than n1. This is the explanation to write this particular statement, right? So I hope you all got the idea. Now let's see second point. In the second point, what they are saying? They are saying 2n photons which are coherent. The number of atoms in the higher energy state must be greater than that in the ground state. Now this is the requirement for the laser. This was E2, this is E1. Here N2 is the number of atoms in excited state, N1 are the number of atoms in ground state. Requirement is what for the coherent light? They are saying N2 should be larger than N1. Only then one can get this coherent light, right, which is required. And coherent means all the photons are in same phase, right? So this is the first point, and the second point is the process of making population of atoms in the higher energy state more than that in the lower energy state is known as population inversion. If we achieve this kind of situation, right, then only we can say we have achieved the population inversion. Or the concept, if you are talking about the concept, it means it is very clear. Earlier here, L1 were the number of atoms in ground state which were larger as compared to the N2. But right now, we are saying that N2 are number of atoms in excited state are larger. So population has been inverted. So in terms of picture, now 3, 4, 5, you can see this was the first case, and now the situation is like this. Here 2, 3, 4, and here large number of atoms you can see. So obviously the population has been inverted. So this is the idea of population inversion. Now the second point, the method by which a population inversion is affected is called optical pumping. Or instead of saying optical pumping, we can say pumping. The pumping is only the process by which we can invert the number of atoms, right? In this process, atoms are raised to an excited state by injecting into some photon of frequency different from the stimulating frequency. The frequency, or you can say the energy of the incident radiation, which is helpful to excite the active medium of the laser, right? That is the point here. That I will explain it further in the particular laser. So if you don't get an idea properly, so this is the meaning actually. Population inversion can be understood with the help of three energy level atomic systems, right? So this was the idea of this was the idea of population inversion. So population inversion, population inversion, how one can achieve that? So there were two, three concepts. One, you have used Maxwell, Boltzmann idea, distribution law. Right, that was n is equal to m naught e raised power minus e upon k t. Right, we have used this equation, and second concept we have used that for the laser light, m2, those are number of atoms in excited state, should be larger as compared to the n1, and we know this is e2, this is e1. So here situation is E2 is greater than still E1. So these were the ideas related to heat If you have any doubt or question, you can ask. Or I can show it in a further with the help of a picture. How basically, in general, the distribution of atoms in ground state with a different energy. So in next video, I will explain by using the three energy level instead of two. So thanks for watching. Keep in touch, and if the information is helpful, then like, share, and distribute the video among your friends.